Hello and welcome. Thank you for coming to this RingCentral for NetSuite demo. My name is Eddie Adder. I'm a senior technology consultant here at Protelo, and I'm one of the lead developers behind this product. So without further ado, I'd like to jump in here and show you some of the system. The first thing I'm going to do is hop into a contact record. So I went ahead and created this demo contact record ahead of time. Jane Doe, she has a phone number here, and you can see that the phone number is hyperlinked. So I will be demoing with contact records, but this will work with any field in NetSuite that's classified as a phone number field, including custom fields. So if I go ahead and click on this, we'll see that a new window pops open for the phone call record. Now, there are two important buttons here. You can see that there's a green phone and then also a dial pad. So the green phone will do something called ring out, and I can demo that here. So if I just press the green phone, and I'm not sure if you can hear that on audio, but my phone is ringing. So if I answer it,
to connect this call, press 1.
So it asks me to connect the call. I just have to press 1. I'm actually just going to hang up for this demo. And you can see that as soon as I hung up, the end time here populated. If I had pressed 1, it would have immediately connected me on my personal phone, but using my work number, to this phone number here, to Jane Doe's phone number. So I'll show you a little bit more detail on how that's configured and where that works and comes from. So if I hop into my telephone settings, so we have a few settings in here. So I have an active phone. In this case, this is my personal number. Maybe I'm working from home, right, and doing most of the work there. And this caller ID is actually my RingCentral number. So that's the caller ID number that everyone else is going to see. So this allows me to use any phone I want. It can be adjusted frequently, right? So if you're in the office, maybe this becomes your office number and rings, say, a landline. When you're working from home, you can just swap this number out. And instead of calling you at your work phone to connect the call, it can call you at your personal phone. There are some other settings here we're going to talk about. These three, but before we do that, I want to show the other feature here. So the other button is this blue dial button here. I'm going to actually put my number in so we don't call anyone unintentionally. And if I press this blue dial number, instead of calling me on my cell phone or maybe a work phone, you can see that it automatically starts dialing from the soft phone. So I rang my own number, that's why my cell phone was ringing, but you can put any number in there. Of course, it'll default to Jane Doe's because that's where we clicked it from, and it will use the soft phone installed on the computer instead. Okay. Now, there are a few settings here that may be helpful. This play prompt is when you're using the ring out one, where it called my cell phone to connect the call. If this is checked, it will say press 1 to connect the call. If it's unchecked, the instant I answer, it's going to connect that call with the other line, the other person. Two click dial is if you're making a lot of phone calls and don't really want to click either of these buttons. So you can have it automatically dial as soon as you click a phone number record. So let me go ahead and show that as well. I'm going to leave play prompt on. I'm going to turn two click dial off, so we become one click dial. And I'm going to uncheck prefer soft phone. So that means it's going to use the ring out feature and call my actual phone. It won't use my computer phone. Okay. So if I save this, and I'm going to close the phone call record and go back to our Jane Doe record here. If I click on the phone now, this time, shortly after the page loads, my cell phone should ring to connect the call. It can say, it says right there, dial in progress, and my phone rings. And if I answer, I should get that
call, press 1.
That same prompt. So if I were to press 1, right, it would start dialing and connecting the call. Just like before, when I hang up, the end time is automatically recorded. And I can add notes here if I want as well. So called lead, did not answer, right? Whatever notes you happen to have, you can include here. And then we can go ahead and save the phone call record. So I'm gonna say Jane Doe lead call, save. So that covers many of the outgoing features of RingCentral. Now I'd like to show some of the incoming features, including screen pop and things like that. So if I close this window, go here, I'm gonna go back to the NetSuite homepage. So you can see I have no other tabs open, just on the homepage of NetSuite. And then I am going to call my work number from my cell phone here to simulate someone calling in.
Okay. Try to connect you.
So you can see the call went through, it popped up on my soft phone, I can choose to answer or send it to voicemail. And I'm gonna go ahead and ignore. And it also automatically popped up a new phone call record here without any interaction on my part. So I can set the status, I can change, you know, the date or anything like that. All pre-populates to today. And again, subject, any notes I want. But the really notable piece is that you can see that the phone number automatically gets pulled in here and it gets associated. So this adder testco, right, has my number that I called from associated with it as the main line. And so it's automatically associated with this company record. Now, a lot of people call from a, you know, single company phone, and maybe they have their own private numbers that they give you their direct line later on after you talk to them. That's very easy. If you need to associate this with a specific contact instead of a company level, you can go in here and just click new contact. And it will pre-populate many of the fields, the phone, the alt email, etc. And you can record their information in there and they'll be automatically associated with that main company as well. As far as the components required, this is all native within NetSuite. The one app that is required is either the RingCentral phone app, or you can use the standard RingCentral app, the all-in-one new version of the app will work as well. That enables the screen pop feature where it brings up the contact record. And it also allows that soft phone functionality should you prefer that instead of calling out on whatever other phone you have. So we don't have time to do as many one-on-one questions today as I would like, but I can go through our list of frequently asked questions. One big one, right, is this is a subscription pricing model. So we will charge a monthly fee based annually, depending on the amount of users you have that are using this integration. So if you only have, 100 users registered with RingCentral, but you only have 10 users with RingCentral and NetSuite that actually need this integration, then you would only need 10 users from us. We're not gonna charge you based on how many RingCentral users you have in your overall system, but instead on how many actually use this integration from within inside NetSuite. With the subscription model, right, we are constantly maintaining this. This is an official SuiteApp registered with NetSuite. That requires us to test at every time a new version of NetSuite comes out to make sure it's still working and functional. If not, we update it, and that's all part of a bundled process. So an update is two clicks on your end. There's absolutely no manual unzipping or installing scripts or anything like that. It's all inside a bundle. So you just press update and you'll have the most recent install. Support is not included. That is a separate add-on build hourly for that. But we do, you know, critical bugs and things like that, of course, we will fix as part of the subscription model. And we are always working to improve all of our suite apps. So if you have any suggestions or recommendations, we'd certainly love to hear it so that maybe we can incorporate it into a future version.